Okay, so now I'm going to demonstrate how to do the Kitchener stitch, which is the very last thing we do on the sock of your knitting before you weave in your tails. So imagine that I have a sock here. This is what yours should look like. I actually have 8 stitches on my needle. You guys will have 6 stitches on your 2 needles. Because what you've done, if you've followed the directions and you've done your toe decreases, you've stopped when you had 6 stitches on needle B and 3 stitches on needles A and C. And then what the instructions say is use needle C to knit needle A. I'm actually going to demonstrate that for you because that might be confusing. So let's divide this up. Okay, so 5th grade, you're going to imagine that I'm at the end of a very long sock here. So I've done my toe decreases and I've stopped when I have 6 stitches on needle B and I've got 3 stitches on needles A and C. So what I'm going to do once I found myself in this place is I want to get down to just 2 needles. So I'm going to use needle C to knit needle A. Now that sounds more confusing than it is. Because if I just slide these to the tips of the needle, I'm ready to just knit those 3 stitches. So now I have 6 stitches on 2 needles. So I've got my 6 stitches on my 2 needles, and I'm going to orient it so that the string is coming from the back needle. I'm going to put my knitting needle aside. There's a couple things that you need now. I'm going to show you how to do a stitch called the Kitchener stitch, which is a very fancy way of casting this off. So you're going to cut your yarn and you want to leave about a foot, about 10 inches, 12 inches, something like that. So you're going to cut your yarn and you're going to thread that onto a tapestry needle. So I'll put my knitting down for a moment. And I've got my tapestry needle threaded onto my yarn. And I've got these altogether 12 stitches that I've got to get off the needle. So the way we're going to do that, there's a little setup stitch. There's a setup stitch that begins this, and then there's a pattern that you can follow. So the setup looks like this. You're going to take the tapestry needle, and you're going to go into the first stitch on the front needle as if to purl. And you're going to pull it through and you're going to leave the stitch on the needle. I'm going to go slow here because I actually recommend you doing this right along with me. I even have to cheat and look up how to do this. This is a tricky stitch to remember. So you first stitch as if to purl and pull it through the needle. Then you're going to take your tapestry needle and go into the first stitch on the back needle as if to knit. Do you see how I'm going in as if I was going to knit that stitch? And you're going to pull it through. Be careful not to catch that on the tip of that needle. Pull it through and leave the stitch on the needle. Now, that was the setup stitch. So here comes the repeating pattern. You're going to go back to the front. And you're going to go through the first stitch on that front needle as if to knit this time. So first stitch on the front needle, pull it through and let that stitch come off. Now you're going to go into the first stitch on the front needle here as if to purl. So you're going to go through as if to purl. And you're going to leave it on the needle. Okay, now we're going to go back to our back stitches. You're going to go through the first stitch as if to purl. And then you're going to slide that first stitch off the back needle. And you're going to go into the first stitch, the next first stitch on the back needle as if to knit. And you're going to leave it on the needle. Okay, so you can see we're taking care of 2 stitches on the front and then 2 stitches on the back. before we switch. So those were the two back ones. Now we're going to go back up to the front again. So the first stitch on the front needle as if to knit, and we slide that stitch off the needle. In a minute I'll show you what this is doing, but I want to do a little more so you can really see. And then we're on the second stitch of the pattern, which is now the first stitch on this needle, and we're going to go in as if to purl and leave it on the needle. Now we're going to go to the first stitch on the back needle as if to purl, and we're going to slip that stitch off the needle. I'm giving it a little tug in between because we need to do that to pull the stitches secure. So now we're on this stitch here. We're going to go into that stitch as if to knit, and we're going to leave it on the needle. Now we're going to go back to the front, and you're going to go into that first stitch as if to knit, and you're going to slide that stitch off the needle. Now we're going to go into the next stitch as if to purl and leave that stitch on the needle. Okay, now we're ready to go to the back ones, and I think after I show you these next two I can show you what's happening here. So now we're going to go into the first stitch on the back needle as if to purl. Pause this video if I'm going too fast for you, and you're going to slide it off the needle. Now you're going to go into the first stitch on the back needle as if to knit, and you're going to leave it on the needle. Now, I wonder if we can get a close-up of what's happening. You can see, I'm going to stick my finger in there to pull it out a little bit. So you're getting this, it almost looks like the continuous line of stitches. The stitches that came from the top are perfectly blended with the stitches that have come from the bottom. So it looks, you can't see the line of casting off right there. So it's this very sort of magical looking thing that happens. I'm going to pull them out a little bit so you can see that. See, I can't tell which is from the top and the bottom. They're all completely stitched together in a way that looks like it's all one continuous line of knitting. Okay, so let's finish this off here. So we just did, let's remind myself, the back needle. So now we're onto the front needle. Okay, so the front needle is always the first stitch as if to knit, and then slide the stitch off the needle. And do give that little tug in between times. And then the second stitch that we're taking care of on this front needle is as if to purl and leave it on the needle. Now the next ones are the back two stitches. So this first one we're going to do, it's as if to purl. The back always begins with as if to purl and sliding off, and then the next stitch as if to knit, leave the stitch on the needle. We're almost done. Okay, front stitch as if to knit, slide the stitch off the needle. Whoops, we don't want to lose that one yet. The next stitch as if to purl, keep it on the needle. It gets a little floppy when there's not many stitches here to hold it secure. So leave that one on the needle. Okay, and we got these last back ones. The first stitch as if to purl, slide it off. The second stitch as if to knit, and leave it on. You can see these last ones get a little tricky, but by this time you should be more comfortable with it. Okay, last two stitches. Front stitch as if to knit. I think I got in there. We're done with that one. And the back stitch as if to purl, and we're done with that one. So you can give a tug, and I'll show you this again. So we've got that beautiful, look at how that goes, where you really cannot tell where the beginning and the end is. So then what I like to do is, since I'm already attached to my tapestry needle, I'm going to just push that inside my sock. For you, you'll have to be reaching down in your sock to pull it through. For me, it's easy. And then it'll be ready to weave in your tails on the other side.